Another wrestler that's always provided a unique interview was known as the man who made Milwaukee famous. He prided himself on, well, let's have him tell you. Let's take a classic look back at the one, the only, the Crusher.
So I'm going to start getting ready for him. I'm going to start eating 6 pounds of Polish sausage a day, increase my beer from a case to a case and a half, and I'm going to eat a lot of mashed potatoes and gravy.
For a body posing contest, potatoes
and gravy. And I'm going to cut down my workout so I really bulk up. Instead of walking a block, I'm going to cut it down to a half a block.
And then ride the other half.
Right.
As we always say, this wrestler needs no introduction whatsoever. He loves to go through the arena, shaking hands with all of his many fans here. Ladies and gentlemen, he is the one, the only, from Milwaukee, the Crusher.
You have any saloons down there?
Well, that I don't know.
Has that bum ever smoked a cigar?
I doubt it.
How many cases of beer a day does he drink?
I wouldn't even venture.
Does he do the polka?
I doubt that, too.
How can he call himself the Crusher? I've been hit with bar stools, bar rags, barmaids, spit tunes. I've been brought up in the saloons of Milwaukee. These are my kind of fights. John L. Sullivan was an idol of mine. Well, the bum knows he can't wrestle me. He knows he ain't going to take a match at me, refuse to wrestle me. So he thinks he's going to humiliate him. How you say that word?
Humiliate.
Right. Me. I tell you right now, the people out there better fasten their seatbelts. I don't care if it's grandma in a wheelchair or if somebody's sitting on their favorite bar stool. This got to be the greatest news to ever hit wrestling.
Holy smokes, I tell you, this Crusher, he just a day he can blow the walls out of any auditorium anywhere.
I'll tell you right now, they better have a sewing machine around there. They're going to need it to sew them tree pumps up.
I'll tell you what, they're talking.
The three of us! One, two, three!
Three.
Three!
The three of you.
The three of us! Because we're going to run them across the cage, in the cage, through the cage, any way we can get them bumps.
Keep setting attendance records wherever he goes. The people just love him.
They might even come all the way from Milwaukee.
Have you ever heard of a town called Ponotuski?
Certainly I did. You ever hear of Stella Wendowski?
I don't believe I've met her.
You'd like her.
No pretenses about this man. He lives extremely well. He earns a lot of money because he is one of the world's greatest wrestlers. 100 megaton bicep.
Does he know that I won Mr. Saloon 10 years in a row in Milwaukee?
Wait a minute.
What do you think, he's some crumb bum he's fooling around with?
10 years in a row, the title of Mr. Saloon?
That's right.
What does it mean?
That means that I'm the best in the world. That title is recognized more than any title in the world because you can win Mr. Saloon. You got to do a lot of things to do that. You got to be able to poker. You got to be able to throw drunks out of the saloon. There's a lot involved.
Hey, just a minute here. A minute in the world. You guys have got to cut this out. For crying out loud, ladies and gentlemen, holy Toledo.
Crusher was crowned the polka king a few years back.
Can you believe it? Ladies and gentlemen, they're running off with my microphone. They are tuned up for the big one just hours away at the Milwaukee Auditorium. 6-man tag team action.
I said, hey, Crusher, how come you can dance so well? He says, I'll tell you what. If I hadn't learned to polka, I probably wouldn't be a good wrestler. He says, it keeps your legs in shape.
Somebody help me. Let's get control. Stay tuned for more action.
And I'm going to, there's a lot of polka joints around that area.
Well, I like to dance that kind of music. It's the best.
That's right. And after I get rid of this big slob, Blackwell, Jerkwell, me and Miss Piggy might go around doing the polka.
By the way,
you think she could dance the polka, Miss Piggy?
I don't know about that.
You aren't going to hurt the Crusher. Hit him in the head.
I had him in the saloons. I had him in the worst joints in the country. And you know they don't exactly talk Sunday school language. I'd walk a million miles for one of your smiles. My dear mother.
A lot of people are going to mistake me for Johnny Cash.
Glad I had him in Milwaukee there, carrying kegs of beer up and down the lake banks. You can imagine how thirsty that gets.
You lose. You got to smoke, not this cigar, regular small cigar, but you got to smoke this cigar. And while you're smoking it, I'm going to be drinking a pitcher of beer. We're going to settle it once and for all. Miss Pig, I might buy you a beer.
I can hit you with the head of a guitar.
Here comes the Crusher Bolo, they know it. A devastating blow. Propelled by a 100 megaton bicep. Leone down. All the Crusher has to do is cover him. Two, three, that's it. That's all she wrote for Tony Leone as the Crusher. Victorious once again on All-Star Wrestling.